Cats, Masters of Evolution and Adaptation, Introduction. Cats are some of the most ubiquitous and widespread animals alive today. They are found in the wild on every continent except Australia and Antarctica and are domesticated practically everywhere. These animals are incredibly diverse. They thrive in numerous different environments, from deserts and jungles to mountains and grasslands, and come in all shapes and sizes. They are among the top predators wherever they are and are highly adaptable. Their success can be traced back to a history of evolutionary advantages that date back to the earliest Cenozoic. Origins and evolution of Carnivora. Cats are part of a group known as Carnivora, which contains all large mammalian land predators. Carnivores arose from the grouping Carnivoromorpha, tree-dwelling carnivores that evolved around 66 million years ago. This family shared some of the key traits of carnivores, such as carnassials, modified shearing teeth meant to consume flesh. It was originally believed that a superfamily inside Carnivoromorpha known as Myocoidea was the origin of our modern carnivorans. This family included the miacids, dog-like carnivores, as well as Viverravidae, civet-like carnivores. Caniformia and Feliformia. There was a thought among scientists that these two groups were ancestral to the two major groups of carnivorans, Caniformia, which contains dogs, bears, and their relatives, and Feliformia, containing cats, hyenas, and their relatives. Some evidence supporting this came in morphological similarities, such as the parallels in how there are more teeth in miacids and caniforms compared to the viverravids and feliforms. But this is highly debated and not widely supported nowadays. Viverravidae is seen as a more basal group of Myocoidea, and the branch point of the dog and cat lineages occurred later on in the Eocene. Early Feliforms. Early Feliforms retained an arboreal lifestyle, setting them apart from the more mobile and ground-dwelling caniforms. In addition, Feliforms also stuck to a more carnivorous diet as opposed to caniforms like bears, which could lead a more omnivorous lifestyle. In addition to these general lifestyle changes, they could also be morphologically differentiated from caniforms by having shorter snouts, more specialized carnassial teeth, and the presence of a double-chambered auditory bulla, bony capsules found within the ear. Feliformia, families and ancestors. Feliformia consists of seven extant families, with cats being listed under the family Felidae. Their closest living carnivore relatives are the members of Prionodontidae, the Asiatic linsangs. These small animals give us a decent look at how earlier felids may have looked. The earliest known felid was the late Oligocene genus Proalerus. Comparing the small cat directly to an Asiatic linsang, we can see some remarkable similarities. They both had long, slender bodies with tails that were proportionately longer compared to those of later cats. They also shared a similar tree-dwelling lifestyle as well. The cat gap. Following Proalerus, however, came a period of time known as the cat gap, where for 7 million years since the emergence of this animal, there was a lack of any new felid fossils, a problem especially prominent in North America. What's more, many of the old feliforms present on the continent, such as the nimravids, showed a sharp decline as well. There are many reasons given for why this gap could have occurred, such as an increase in hypercarnivorous behavior of some species paired with an increase in body size, meaning that any absence or decline of large prey species would be extremely detrimental to these carnivores. Habitat loss is also brought up as a valid reason for the cat gap. An interesting theory posits that dogs and their caniform relatives began evolving many cat-like characteristics, potentially taking the place of feliforms in North America. For instance, some dogs during the Miocene had specialized elbows that would have made it easier to pounce on prey, similar to cats. However, scientists have yet to find any caniforms during this gap that directly occupied former feliform niches and ecosystems, making this theory still shaky. End of the cat gap and evolution of Felidae. The cat gap came to an end after the genus Sudilurus entered North America 18.5 million years ago, having evolved 1.5 million years prior. Sudilurus is seen as a direct descendant of Proalerus, although given the length of time between the evolution of both animals, there are likely other genera connecting the two. This cat, which could grow to be as large as a puma, rapidly spread and diversified into many different branches of cats. Sooty lurus is notable for being ancestral to all other modern cat groups as well as several extinct groups like the Macarodontinae. Saber-toothed cats and other extinct groups. The Macarodontinae, a line of cats home to powerful saber-toothed predators like Smilodon and Homotherium, is one of the extinct groups derived from Sooty lurus. It's worth noting that Macarodontinae was not the only line of saber-toothed predators in Feliformia. There were also two former groups, the Nemravidae, a far more basal Feliform group, and the Barborophelidae, a sister group more closely related to the Felids than the Asiatic Linsangs. These lines of carnivores were also known for having many false saber-toothed cats. Evolution of Felidae. Felidae, the family that includes all modern cats, evolved in Asia sometime during the Miocene epoch. Felids possess several physical traits such as great eyesight and hearing, rough tongues to help extract meat from prey, cushioned feet, and, with the exception of a few cats such as the cheetah, retractable claws with sheaths to protect them. These adaptations help them become efficient predators, and their unique features, such as retractable claws, set them apart from other carnivores. This has led to cats outcompeting many old branches of carnivorans in places they migrate to, such as North America, where they became especially prominent. Pantherinae and Felinae. Felidae today consists of two major branches, Pantherinae and Felinae, which split off around 10 million years ago. Pantherinae consists of two closely related genera, Neophelis and Panthera. These two groups split off from one another about 6.4 million years ago. The Neophelis genus contains the clouded leopard and the Sunda clouded leopard, cats found in Southeast Asia with several defining characteristics such as a cloudy pattern on their fur and elongated canines similar to those found in Macarodontines. Panthera, the big cats. Panthera contains what people colloquially refer to as the big cats. Our understanding of pantherine evolution is still a little fuzzy, with the earliest member of Panthera, the Miocene Panthera blithii, sharing more in common with snow leopards than with all other big cats. As a result, we can safely assume that Panthera must trace back its evolution a little bit further. Among Panthera, the snow leopard and the tiger, as well as close relatives such as the Longdan tiger, are sister groups. In addition, the jaguar, lion, leopard, and extinct species like the American lion, cave lion, and European jaguar are more closely related to one another than to the snow leopard and tiger, separated from them by about 3.5 million years of evolution. Differences in Panthera. Pantherines all share very similar morphology, and almost all of them have the ability to roar. The one exception to this is the snow leopard, which is unable to roar due to its shorter vocal folds. Despite their many similarities, the lifestyles of the Pantherines can differ immensely. Some members of Panthera, such as the tiger, are solitary hunters, while others, like lions, are incredibly social animals that work in groups. Felinae, the purring cats. When we think about big cats, people also often lump in animals like the cheetah, puma, lynx, and many other large felid predators. However, these animals belong to the second extant branch of Felidae, the Felinae. Felinae is the most widespread group of cats alive today. They are differentiated from Pantherines by their ability to purr, a trait they possess due to their shorter vocal cords. Felinae can be broken up into seven different lineages of cats. Catopuma and Pardofelis lineages. The first of these lineages diverged 9.4 million years ago and contains the bay cat and Asian golden cat under the genus Catopuma. These two cats split off from one another roughly 5 million years ago when Borneo was connected to the nearby archipelago. This line also contains the marbled cat, listed under the genus Pardofelis. These cats are found from the Himalayas in South Asia to islands such as Borneo in Southeast Asia. Caracal and Serval lineages. The next branch of Felinae diverged 8.5 million years ago and consists of several medium-sized African and Asian cats. This group contains the Servaline Caracal and its rainforest cousin, the African golden cat, as well as the genus Leptolurus, which contains the serval. An interesting fact is that the Caracal was present as far east as India, which is often associated with African fauna. South American cats. The third lineage contains numerous different elusive South American cat species. This group first evolved 8 million years ago in North America, migrating to South America when the Panama Land Bridge connected the two continents around 3 million years ago. These cats are all listed under the genus Leopardus, which ranges from Central to South America. They include the Jeffrey's cat, the Northern Tiger cat, the Southern Tiger cat, the Codcod, the Uncilla, the Pampas cat, the Andean Mountain cat, the Ocelot, and the Margay. Given South and Central America's diverse set of biomes and ecosystems, Leopardus can be found in all sorts of regions, from rainforests to grasslands and high altitudes. Lynx lineage. Fourth is a branch made up of cats under the genus Lynx, which split off 7.2 million years ago. These are the Eurasian lynx, the Iberian lynx, the Canada lynx, and the bobcat. These cats evolved in North America but later spread to Eurasia, where they evolved into newer forms. Today, they are found in colder northern regions from Canada and the US to Eurasia and Spain, where there have been major efforts to reintroduce them to their former habitats. Puma and cheetah lineages. The fifth lineage, diverging 6.7 million years ago, contains cats typically associated with big cats, the cheetah under the genus Acininix and the puma or cougar under the genus Puma. This genus also includes the smaller relative of both these animals, the jaguarundi, under the genus Herpalurus, found in South and Central America. The puma and jaguarundi are more closely related to one another than to the cheetah. Recent studies indicate that the ancestors of cheetahs also evolved in North America before crossing the Bering Land Bridge into Eurasia and finally Africa. However, while cheetah ancestors evolved in North America, the genus of the cheetah itself, Acininix, evolved and spread only throughout the Old World. Extinct cheetahs such as the American cheetah are more closely related to the puma than their African cousins. The cheetah's lack of retractable claws helps it maintain traction while running at high speeds. Smallest wild cats. The sixth lineage contains some of the smallest wild cat species, diverging 6.2 million years ago. These are listed under the genus Prionaelurus, containing the Sunda leopard cat, the fishing cat, the leopard cat, the flat-headed cat, and the rusty-spotted cat, the smallest wild cat in the world. These cats are found all over South and Southeast Asia. Additionally, this branch contains the Pallas's cat under the genus Odocolobus, found throughout Central Asia. Felis lineage and domestication. The last group in Felinae is the Felis lineage, which diverged 3.4 million years ago. This includes the jungle cat, the Chinese mountain cat, the European wild cat, the African wild cat, the sand cat, and the black-footed cat. The African wild cat, Felis libica, used to be separated into two species, the African and Asian wild cat. However, they are now grouped together under one species. The African wild cat is also the closest relative and likely ancestor of the domesticated cat, Felis catus. The earliest evidence of cat domestication dates back to 9,500 years ago in Cyprus, with earlier evidence suggesting it occurred in Egypt and the Fertile Crescent 10,000 years ago. Human-cat relationship. Compared to the taming of wolves, the domestication of cats followed a different path, wherein cats were attracted to human settlements due to rodents that would feed on their grain. Over time, humans and cats grew closer, leading to their eventual domestication. Domestic cats have since become a staple across human households worldwide and have even managed to hybridize with several wild species. Some hybrids, such as Bengals, crosses between domestic cats and Asian leopard cats, and Savannas, crosses between domestic cats and Servals, are quite popular. Others, like the Caracal, a domestic cat and Caracal hybrid, are less well known. Conclusion. From their origins as small tree-dwelling creatures, cats have diversified and expanded their reach across the world. Their specialized adaptations over millions of years of evolution have led to all kinds of unique cats, from large predators like tigers and lions to extremely fast runners like cheetahs to more specialized smaller carnivores. Their domestication has only led to their continued success as an overall group, making them one of the most popular animals on Earth. Additional note. Hey guys, thanks for watching the video. If you enjoyed it, make sure to give it a like, subscribe, and stay tuned for more uploads. Also, don't forget to recommend any video ideas you have for me in the comments below.